That's why the great authoritative shuyukh and scholars, right from North America to the Arab world and from East to West, they are here. And I congratulate and I am thankful to Jami al-Azhar, the Grand Sheikh al-Azhar al-Imam al-Akbar, al-Daktur al-Sayyid Ahmad Muhammad al-Tayyib. He has sent his very big, high-ranking delegate under the headship of the president of Al-Azhar, sitting president himself. They have sponsored, they have supported and endorsed this conference. I want to address my youth of Muslim Ummah, those who are lost, those who are misguided, those who have been brainwashed, those who have been given totally a wrong perception and conception of Islamic teachings, those who have a total misconcept of jihad and Islam and Iman, and they consider that fighting against humanity, fighting against non-combatant Muslim is their duty. I want to send them a message by, for the sake of God and for the sake of Quran and for the sake of the Sunnah of Holy Prophet, come back to normal life. Whatever you are doing, that is totally against Islam. Islam is just about peace. Islam is just about tolerance. Islam is just about openness. Islam is just about love. Islam is just about accommodation. Islam is just about mutual trust. Islam is just about mutual respect. Islam is just about a dialogue, culture of dialogue. Udhu ila sabili rabbika bil hikmah. Islam has nothing to do with any act of terrorism. It may be in any form, it may be in any kind, maybe in any manifestation. We reject every act of extremism and terrorism in its totality, unconditionally and in absoluteness. I always used to say, don't follow Usama, follow Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And don't follow Al-Qaeda, follow Al-Quran. Don't follow anybody, follow Ahlul Bayt, Ahlul Bayt Rasulullah. And don't follow any person, follow Khulafa'i Rashideen and companions of Prophet Muhammad. Follow Abu Bakr and follow Umar. Follow Usman and follow Ali. These are our leaders. These are our leaders, our ideals, our role models. Not a single non-Muslim was harmed by them. Not a right of any non-Muslim was infringed by them. My dear audience, my dear youth, dear Muslims of present time, we have to take a decision today. Which is the standard Islam given by the crazy criminal people, given by the extremists and terrorists, given by the illiterate and ignorant people who have their own political negative agendas, and those who are killers of mankind, and those who are building the walls of hatred to divide the mankind? Are you going to get the standard definition of Islam from them? Or we are supposed to get the definition of Islam from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam through the pledge of Aqaba?